In this tutorial, we will create this plan. Before we start working on this plan, I want to announce we have crossed 150k subscribers, and I want to thank you all of you for the great support. Now we will start creating this plan. To create this plan, start SketchUp, then click on the arrow before the template and select this construction documentation millimeters. Then click on Start using SketchUp. Now in this plan, at first we will create one rectangle of 8600 mm by 7600 mm size. Click on Rectangle. Specify start point for the rectangle. Take your cursor away. Then specify the size. At first you will have to specify size in the red axis, that is horizontal size, which is 7600, comma vertical size, that is size in green axis, that is 8600. Then press enter. Then click on zoom fit. I don't want to view this color. To remove this color, click on View, click on Face Style, and select Wireframe. And if we zoom minus, I don't want to view this Z axis like this. To remove this Z axis, click on Camera and select Parallel Projection. Now in this plan, the wall thickness is 300 mm. At first, click on Select. Then press first mouse button and drag the mouse and release the mouse. It will select the rectangle. Then click on Offset. Then select any one line. Take your cursor inside and give the distance of 300 and press Enter. Then to switch back to select tool, you can also press spacebar and click outside. So this wall is created. Now in this plan, first dimension is horizontal length and second dimension is vertical length. So we need to create this vertical wall. It will be at a distance of 3000, that is internal clear distance is 3000. To create a reference axis, click on Tape Measure tool, then click on this line, take your cursor on this side and give the distance of 3000 and enter. Then wall thickness will be 300. Again click on this reference line, take your cursor on this side, give the distance of 300, enter. Then next will be, here is a door opening of D size. D is 1000 mm. We can create reference line at a distance of 1000. Click on this line, take your cursor above, give the gap of 1000, enter. Click on this reference line, take your cursor above, give the gap of 300, enter. Then next is the vertical gap for this room is 3700. Select this line, take your cursor above, give the gap of 3700, enter. Again select this line, take your cursor above, give the gap of 300 for wall. Reference line is created for this wall and this wall. Then here the gap is 4000. Click on this line, take your cursor above, give 4000, enter. Again select this line, take your cursor above, give the gap of 300, enter. Click on select tool. Next is to create these walls. First we will create this wall and this wall. For that we will use the rectangle tool. Click on rectangle or shapes, then give first point, give second point, again give first point here and second point here. Then next will be this wall, give first point, second point, and this wall, first point, second point. And here we will need one vertical line. For that we will use this line tool. Click on lines, give first point, give second point. Then we need to remove this reference line and some unwanted lines. For that we will use erase. Click on eraser. To use erase, just press first mouse button and drag the mouse. As it crosses the object, it becomes blue. That means it will be erased. And release the mouse. So those objects will be erased. Then actually we will need one horizontal line here, so that we can erase this portion. Click on line tool and give first point, give second point. Then again click on erase. Press first mouse button and drag the mouse and release the mouse. So it will be erased. Same way here. You can also erase by clicking on the object. We will pan it. To pan, press shift, press middle mouse button and drag the mouse. Or you can also pan from here. Just click on it, press first mouse button and drag it. And to come out of this pan, right click and exit. Then next will be to create this portion. Now here this vertical gap is 1200 and horizontal gap is 2150. Then here wall thickness is 200 and we will take this distance as 300. So at first we will create this gap of 1200. For that again click on this tape measure tool, zoom this. To zoom, just rotate your middle mouse button towards monitor, it will zoom it. Click on this line, take your cursor above, give the distance of 1200, enter. Again click on this reference line, take your cursor above, give the distance of 200, enter. And click on this line, give this direction, give the distance 2150, enter. Same way on this side 200. Then we need one more reference at 300 distance. Again click, give direction, give distance. Then here this room size is 1200 by 1000. Then 1000 is already there, we can check it. Click on this point, take your cursor above. So it is showing distance of 1000. Escape. Now we will create this gap of 1200. Click on this line, 1200. Enter. Select this line, 200. Enter. Then we will create the rectangles. Click on rectangle. Give the first point from here, give second point, first point, second point, and again first point, second point. And we will need one line here. Click on line, give first point, second point. Then remove the unwanted portion. We can also activate eraser tool by pressing E on keyboard. Press E, press first mouse button and drag the mouse. It will be erased. Or you can also erase by clicking on it. Then zoom fit, click on zoom fit, zoom extend, pan it. Now it is created properly. Then next will be to create door openings. Now at first we will create these three door openings because their size is same. The size is D1, that is 900, and we will keep this gap of 150. Click on tape measure tool. Click on this line, take your cursor below, give the gap of 150, enter. Select this line, give the gap of 900, enter. Repeat the same procedure here, 150, enter, 900, enter. Then create rectangle. You can activate rectangle tool by pressing R on keyboard. Press R, give first point, give second point. First point, second point. Give it carefully. Then remove the unwanted object. Press E. Zoom fit. Okay, zoom fit. Then next is, this door opening is already there. We will check it. D2 size is, D2 is 800. We will check that whether this distance is 800 or not. For that, click on tape measure tool. Select this point and take your cursor on this line. So here this distance is 750, we need it 800, we will move this portion. Click on move. So before that, actually you will have to select the object, press spacebar. For select tool, drag the mouse and release it. Press control for multiple selection and click on this line. Then select move. Click on this point, give the direction, give the distance of 50, enter. And check the distance. Here the distance is 800, that is correct. Now this opening is created. Then here is also door of 800 size. Now total size is 1000, therefore we will keep 100 on either side. Click on this line, give 100. And take rectangle, press R, give first point, second point, press E and erase this. Zoom fit. So openings are also ready now. And erase here and here. Now in this tutorial we have created walls and openings. Now in the next tutorial we will create doors and windows. Thanks for watching. We will stop here.